Hello, and welcome to the IRF and LTCH training, part one. I'm Brenda Karkus, and I'll be presenting section K, swallowing nutritional status, and section H, bowel and bladder. I'm a registered nurse with experience in direct patient care, education, and nursing administration. My experience includes inpatient care, outpatient oncology, home health, and hospice settings. Currently, I'm an associate nurse researcher at Apt Associates in Cambridge, Mass. At the conclusion of this lesson, you should be able to describe the new and revised data elements in Section K, discuss the intent, coding instructions, and definitions for the Section K items, and explain the changes to coding instructions for the Section H items related to bowel and bladder continence. Now let's take a closer look at what's included in this section, nutritional approaches. The data elements in this section are new to the IRF and LTCH assessment instruments on admission and discharge. These include parenteral intravenous or IV feeding, feeding tube, mechanically altered diet, and therapeutic diet. K0110, swallowing and nutritional status, has now been removed from the IRF-PAI. The intent of K0520 is that there are many conditions that can impact a patient's ability to maintain adequate nutrition and hydration. The items in this section are intended to assess this. And here's the rationale for this item. When patients must rely on mechanically altered food or other methods for their nutrition, such as feeding tubes, this can diminish their sense of dignity and self-worth, and certainly the pleasure and enjoyment one gets from eating real foods. However, based on the patient's clinical condition, they may benefit from various nutritional approaches that are included in this section. Here are just a few definitions to get us started. While I won't read the entire definition, since most of you would be quite familiar with these, I will just say that parenteral or IV feeding is nutrition that avoids the GI tract, while a feeding tube delivers nutrition directly into the GI system. And a few more definitions to differentiate a therapeutic diet from a mechanically altered diet. A therapeutic diet would be a prescribed diet as part of a treatment for a disease or condition. For example, a low sodium diet. And a mechanically altered diet is one that alters the texture or the consistency of the food to facilitate oral intake, like pureed foods or thickened liquids. And this is just a screenshot of this item. You can see that on admission, one would be assessing whether there are any of these nutritional approaches being used. On admission, you would check all that apply for parenteral or IV feeding, feeding tube, mechanically altered diet, therapeutic diet, or check Z for none of the above. K0520 looks a little bit different on discharge. While you are assessing these same elements, you're going to check the first column labeled number 4 for all that apply in the last 7 days, and the second column labeled number 5 for all that apply at discharge. And as with admission, you would check Z if none of these apply for either column. Now let's look at some of the coding guidance for this new item. First, here's a list of some of the data sources that can be used to complete these items. These might include the medical record, whether it be a paper or electronic health record, from wherever the patient received care, other available documentation or notes from pharmacy, nursing staff, or the physician or physician designee, or perhaps other clinical staff such as the dietitian. And you might also include discussions with the hospital staff, the patient, their family, or perhaps other caregivers. So here are the steps for assessment, which I've already mentioned. On admission, you're going to review the medical record or available documentation to determine if any of these apply. And then at discharge, look to see if any were applicable for the last 7 days to complete column 1, or at discharge for column 2. And here you can see all of the choices again for K0520. And one difference of note in the coding guidance for LTCH is that it states for the LCDS, you will complete only if AO250 is 01 admission. And on discharge, you'll review all of these same choices again for the last 7 days and at discharge. Just one note regarding the difference in the coding guidance for LTECs. For the LCDS, complete only if AO250 is 10 planned discharge or 11 unplanned discharge. Now let's just walk through a few specific coding tips. If there is supporting documentation indicating the need for additional fluid intake, specifically to address a nutrition or hydration need, the fluids mentioned here in the yellow box may be included. IV fluids or hyperalimentation, including TPN, whether continuous or intermittent, hypodermoclysis and sub-Q ports for hydration, and IV fluids if needed to prevent dehydration, if that additional fluid intake is specifically needed for nutrition and hydration. The supporting documentation would be defined by your facility policy and should be noted in the patient's medical record. Here are some items that would not be coded in K0520A. IV medications, IV fluids used to reconstitute or dilute medications for administration purposes, IV fluids that are a routine part of an operative or diagnostic procedure, or IV fluids given just to flush the line. You also would not include parenteral or IV fluids given in conjunction with chemotherapy or dialysis. Now some tips for therapeutic diet. You would code enteral feeding formulas as a therapeutic diet only when used to manage problematic health conditions such as diabetes. Enteral feeding formulas are not coded as a mechanically altered diet. Another tip for therapeutic diets, these diets provide specific nutritional requirement to remedy a particular disease or clinical condition. And one last coding tip for K0520D. A nutritional supplement does not constitute a therapeutic diet, but may be part of a therapeutic diet, although it could be given as part of the treatment for a disease or condition. Supplements are only coded in here if they are being taken as part of a therapeutic diet to manage problematic health conditions. One example might be a supplement for protein-calorie malnutrition. Food elimination diets that are related to food allergies can be coded as a therapeutic diet, such as peanut allergy. Okay, so here is an update for LTECH only about K0200A height and K0200B weight. These items do not exist in the IRF-PAI. You can see the change noted in blue on this slide. The coding instructions have been enhanced to say only enter a height and weight that has been directly measured by your facility staff. Do not enter a height or weight that is self-reported or derived from documentation from another provider setting. And for K0200B weight, this should be measured in accordance with the hospital's policies and procedures, which should reflect current standards of practice. What has been added in blue and says, for example, in the morning, after voiding with shoes off. Now let's move to section H, HO350 bladder continence and HO400 bowel continence. Here is a screenshot of HO350 bladder continence item, which is for a 3-day assessment period. I'm sure this is familiar to you as this item is unchanged, but there is some additional information added to the coding instructions. This slide notes the updated coding instructions for the item. These minor changes were for coding numbers 2, 3, and 4, and were based on questions being raised about exactly when to use these codes. There were no changes to the other codes. You can see the additional language that was added to the coding instructions for these 3 codes, and this is highlighted in blue. For code 2, incontinent less than daily, this now says, if during the 3-day assessment period, the patient was incontinent of urine once or twice and had at least one continent void during the three-day assessment period. Code 3, incontinent daily, now says, if during the three-day assessment period the patient was incontinent of urine at least once a day and had at least one continent void during the three-day assessment period. And code 4, always continent, says if during the three-day assessment period the patient had no continent voids and no catheterization. Now let's look at a few changes to the bowel continence item on the next slide. So here is a screenshot of H0400 bowel continence item, which is also for a three-day assessment period. As with the bladder continence item, the item itself is unchanged, but there is now some additional information added to the coding instructions for this item. So these are the updated coding instructions for H400. These are minor changes. You can see the additional language that was added to the coding instructions for two of these codes, highlighted in blue. No changes were made to the other codes. For code 1, occasionally incontinent, states if during the three-day assessment period the patient was incontinent for bowel movement once, but also had at least one continent bowel movement. This includes incontinence of any amount of stool at any time. The additional language is, but also had at least one continent bowel movement. And code 9, not rated, states if during the three-day assessment period, the patient had an ostomy for another device for bowel elimination, or the patient did not have a bowel movement during the entire 3 days. The additional language here for bowel elimination when referring to the ostomy or other device. So just to summarize, we described K0520, the new data element for Section K, admission and discharge. We also reviewed the intent and coding instructions and some definitions for Section K, and we learned about the changes to coding instructions for Section H items. In closing, if you'd like to submit a question regarding this presentation, please send it to the PAC training at econometricainc.com by June 3rd. As a reminder, a practice coding workshop will be held in June, and we do encourage you to attend. Select questions will be answered in a Q&A session during this June 2022 virtual live event. Thank you for reviewing this presentation, and we look forward to your attendance at the coding workshop.